So let us now write down KCL at the second node. KCL at node B. So this is my node B, and like always, let's refine three outgoing currents, number one, number two, and number three. KCL equation for this current, which is flowing away from node B towards node A, will be nothing but VB minus VA upon 10, plus the current in this vertical branch will be VB. On this side, it is ground, so it's simply VB upon 50. Plus this current will be VB minus, on this side we have VC, divided by 20. So that's my current. These are three currents added. This will be equal to zero. And once again, if we simplify this, we get, first there's a term for VA, it's VA minus VA by 10. VB common, the constant terms will be 1 upon 10 plus 1 upon 50 plus 1 upon 20. And third term is minus VC upon 20 equal to zero. So on simplifying this, we get minus 0.1 VA plus 0.17 VB minus 0.05 VC equal to zero. And this is my equation number two. So only one last step remains, which will be KCL equation at node C. So let's do it. KCL at node C. Now at node C, again, there are three branches. As you can see, you can define three outgoing currents. These are the two outgoing currents. Here there's a current source already, so instead of defining outgoing current, we will stick to the direction of the current source, which is incoming to the node C. Now, if I write down expressions of the various currents, now before we write KCL at node C, let's see what are the expressions of various currents. This current will be through 20 ohm resistance going away from node C towards node B. It will be VC minus VB upon 20. So that's my first term. Plus, we first add all the outgoing currents, and on the other side, we will write the only incoming current. So let me quickly mention this, the incoming current is 2. So now I have to just write down current in this particular branch. Now we come across a problem. The problem is there is a voltage source in this branch, but there is no resistance. Generally, what happens is there is a voltage source along with a resistance. So for example, in this case, when we wrote the expression for the current, it was VA minus 80 upon 50. But here I can write VC minus 20, but there is nothing to divide with. The resistance in this branch is zero. So in simple words, I cannot define current in this branch. So now we make one very important point. The point says that whenever there is no resistance in the branch and only the voltage source between the two nodes, then you can't define current through that particular branch. In fact, there is no requirement of defining current through that branch, because you will immediately see that there is no need to write KCL at this particular node C. Because we can't define current through this branch, we can't write KCL also at node C. And I'm saying that there is no need for the KCL at this particular node C. All right. But before that, I repeat, because there is a voltage source and no resistors between the two nodes, I cannot write KCL at that particular node.